Hey all, welcome to my channel, welcome to John's Model Making. Today I've got another build. It's not exactly a new build, it's an old build. It is from Hachette, but it was distributed many years ago. And it's, there we go, the Lancaster Bomber. This is the wooden version. I know the diecast version will be out, well, maybe 6 months, 12 months, who knows. There we go, there's issue one. It's 125 issues this. I've got every issue, I've done a complete inventory check. Nearly got that word out then. And everything is there. Excellent stuff, of course. I bought this complete set about 3 months ago, I think it is now. Maybe slightly longer actually. So I've been dying to get it done. Well, there we go. But one thing or another has just delayed it and delayed it. Because it, I do need to take my time with it being wooden. The first issue is, where are we? There we go, those are the instructions. The owner, or previous owner I should say, filed everything separately. Instructions in one folder and the history of the plane in another folder. So that's great for me, that's issue two. By the time you see this video, I probably will have done a few of these issues. I'm not going to put issue one on straight away. As soon as I've done it, I'm going to build up a few issues and then you can get a better look at what this build is going to be like. So this is brilliant, very meticulously laid out in these folders. There we go, the Lancaster Bomber part one. This obviously is a history of the bomber itself, which looks absolutely fantastic. Development of the Avro 683 Lancaster. It goes on and on, of course. Then we've got issue two, all the way to issue 125. Anyway, that's looking fantastic, is it not? So you'll, what I will do, this will be obviously for issue one, and then further issues I shall add on. I'll just put a short intro on and then we'll go straight into the build. Probably because it's wooden, it's going to take time this, so I will speed it up and I'll probably chop it, edit it a little bit as well, so as the videos aren't too long for you. And I'll add some music as well. So, that's another thing. There you go, I've already started building it. There, that's the for the tools. That came in its frame. I just built it up, and here we have the tools that came with it. There's a clamp, there's a rivet maker, ruler, that's a steel ruler, it's like a circular file, tweezers, and some scalpels, some blades, wobbly jobbly. Excellent stuff. That's now set. Well, I do need this. Got to get the angles right. Excellent stuff. So anyway, I'm really looking forward to this. So please enjoy the build. I'm not going to be putting the instructions on. It's pointless because nobody else will probably be doing this. Because like I say, I think it's at least 10 year old, this build. So anyway, without further ado, let's get on with the build. Thank you. There we go. That is issue one complaint. Those stringers took forever and a day. Must have took me an hour and a half this morning just to get them in place. Cut them. You don't get much left either, to be honest. That's all that's left. But it's looking good. I used two different types of glue because I couldn't make my mind up which one to use. I wanted the gel one, so I bought some Gorilla Glue, but that was too gloopy. I ended up using the normal Loctite, but it did take a long time. But it's satisfying, it's done. Excellent. There we go, lads. Issue one complete. I can't believe it took that long. Those stringers were a nightmare. Looked so easy on the videos that I've watched. Some of them went on perfectly easily, but others were just won't lay flat. But anyway, obviously they have to go with the curvature of the frame and everything. But some went down perfect, others wouldn't. But anyway, it's done. On to issue two now. Okay, on issue two. There we go. These are all numbered, which is brilliant, so I can take them out and get rid of the frame. And we got a propeller spinner, a wing root former, front spar, rear spar, and then five wing formers. So let's get the parts out. There we go. There's the propeller spinner. Very metallic and heavy. That looks brilliant. We'll be painting the propeller blades and that spinner later. But first of all, I need to get all these out of here. There we go, that's all the parts out. There's the frame, can get rid of that now. Now it's just a case of checking to make sure that all these connections, these cutouts, are clear of any debris, basically. Excellent. Okay, so we need part 20 and part 18. Alright. There we go. What we need now is that piece. Make sure we get the right angle. Excellent. Now we'll try the others and see how we get on. Okay, well they all fit nicely there, but what I need to do is take these off and start gluing and make sure we get the correct angle with this, and we use PVA glue. Thank you. Oh, whilst that is drying off, what we need to do with the propeller now is to actually prime it along with the spinner and then blacken it. Now I've got some primer. There we go. Fine surface primer. I have rubbed it down here on this blade. That's got rid of the roughness on it, and it should be fine on that. And we'll also have to prime that little beast as well. So back in a minute. There we go. That's the propeller blade primed. And there's the spinner. Need a bit of black on it now. Okay, no, there we go. There's the blade. All the blades for the propeller. There's the spinner. All nicely blackened up. I'll do the yellow tips in a couple of days once this is hardened up. Got to mask it off and make sure I don't damage any of that paintwork there. Well, that's looking brilliant. Well, there we go, guys. That's issue one and issue two of this Wooden Lancaster Bomber. I didn't tell you, but it is a 132 scale. I don't have any other specs other than that, to be honest. They're not included with the info I've got, so I don't know exactly how big it measures exactly. Well, it'll be the same as the what is it, the new one, the diecast one that'll be coming out, maybe 6 months, maybe 12 months, we'll wait and see. But anyway, it's looking good. I'm pretty pleased with it up to now. It's looking pretty good. It's taken a long time, long time, but that's better, to be honest. I prefer it like that. The other part works, they're over and done with within half an hour at the most. But as I said before, this with all stringers, took me a good couple of hours, and I've got put stringers on that yet, as well as the other parts of the wing, the formers. So anyway, I hope you did enjoy that. Issue 3 and 4 will be out as soon as I've got time to do them. Hopefully they'll be out in a couple of days after this one, but we'll wait and see. But anyway, if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you soon. So thanks for tuning in and watching. Bye for now.